So you ended up culling by midday, noon?
9:45. I culled my last one. I didn't catch it.
This morning we had a lot of cloud cover. It was really nice and cool, and then it turned the humidity and heat up.
It got hot. I was sitting back in a protected cove, and I got around the cove, and the wind started blowing. I was like, all right, well, the wind's blowing. I'm going to go find a protected cove. And then I went all the way back from the backside of the lake, all the way back around to my point that I always fish. Or should I say my little pocket that I always fish by the dam.
Your spot, yeah?
Yeah. I got over there, and it was dead calm.
Oh, yeah.
After paddling the whole way through all the waves and everything else, got over, it was dead calm, didn't catch any fish there. Came around the boat ramp and caught a couple.
Pretty good limit. Yeah, well, it's seeming like Decker's might be slowing down a tiny bit from what it was on the big bite. But
yeah.
I had still
one
out there.
Yeah, I had one today that was probably 23, 24, but I had three fish today that when they hit, they got wrapped up. And I actually had to pull the kayak over to get them off as they were hanging there, trying to get them out. And
so you were working the reeds?
Oh, yeah, I worked the reeds solid.
That was it, yeah.
Solid, yeah. The fish were busting first thing this morning. They were hitting on the edges. I pulled them all off the edge of the reeds, and I did punch a couple back in the reeds.
Yeah.
Earlier, I probably had one that was about 5.5, 6 pounds that I got out, up and was trying to get back through the reeds, and I couldn't get it out.
Yeah, well, that's where we saw the action today was the guys that were in the reeds, and we, you know, the stuff that we pulled, we didn't get out in the main body of water today at all. So there was nothing out in open water. So. Well, it's good. Good luck to you.
I hope you did real good.
Appreciate it. Well, Cody Berkeley comes in. How's your day, Cody?
It's good.
He's smiling. Like, yeah, that's good.
I like this lake a lot now.
So how'd you do?
Oh, first fish of the morning, he was a 17-inch fish. I put him on the board to take a picture, and then he flopped off, and so that kind of
your first one comes off the board.
Yeah.
Really?
Yeah. So
all the way off, you didn't say.
That wasn't a good way to start the day, but then I backed that one up with a 19-inch fish, and then immediately after I caught the 19, I caught a 20 3/4.
There you go.
And then those were my only two fish for until noon. Or almost one.
Out in the heat.
And then I caught an 18. And then I just ground out two more little ones, 16 and 16.5, and 14.
So you got with the five, you weren't in cull territory at all?
No, I would have been.
You would have been.
I started right where the end of the dam met the reeds, and that's where I hooked that 17. And then I just fished the whole bank line in that first little cove, and then about midday I moved around to that big cove, and that's where I caught my 18 or my last three fish.
Well, so it was fruitful in one spot.
Oh yeah.
Your last day, that's pretty good. And you stayed there for the rest of the time and really didn't...
I mean, there wasn't much time left when I got there, but...
Right. Well, it's been getting better and late in the day, but I think that's slowing down a little bit. So it seems like what the lake was doing is not quite there anymore.
I went in a big dry spill there mid-morning. And I think that this pressure, you know, the past couple days, there's been guys that have just been whacking them. But yeah. I think the pressure's got them messed up. It's going to mess them up from now on until, you know.
Yeah.
And so yeah, I think it slowed down the fish a little bit.
It's the heat of this.
But yeah.
Well, good luck today.
Thanks,
hope you do real well. Good to see you, man. Right, here with Brian Tucker.
See you.
Had a good day, huh?
I did.
Seems like you did, yeah.
Turned in a limit, had 81 and a half. Earlier this morning, I caught quite a few schoolies. I had found them pre-fishing Tuesday, so I had a limit by 7 o'clock. One of the biggest fish that I had, I set the hook on and on a Bama rig, and it took a hard run and jerked the rod out of my hands. I
really?
Just barely managed to grab it before it went off the end of my boat. And got it into the boat, and that was my biggest fish that I turned in. So.
Wow, really?
Yeah.
Oh, man, I almost ripped it out.
Yeah.
And what were you doing today? What were you throwing?
I threw the Bama rig earlier this morning, and then I threw one of those Z-Man Pop Shads.
Pop Shad.
Oh, yeah,
okay, yeah,
yeah.
I've seen that.
Yeah.
Pretty cool.
And they work great. So I was having a great time.
That's
but once it heated up, then fishing cooled down.
And you stayed in one spot? Did you move around?
I stayed in one spot most of the day. I went to check a second spot to see if it had any action. It didn't, so I just went back. And
you know, I was impressed today that I thought because it's Saturday it was going to be heavily pressured and a lot of people on all the spots. It wasn't too bad.
Yeah.
It really wasn't too bad. It seemed like it spread out pretty well.
Yeah, we had just the right number. I think everybody had a good spot to fish. So.
Yeah. Well, good. Good luck
right.
to you. I hope
appreciate
you had a good
it.
Day, man.
Thanks.
Chris Fowler, Team Croat Eagers, comes in. I had to drag your ass up here.
Yeah.
How was your day?
It was a brutal day out there, Chico.
Hot, huh? Hot and heavy.
Not even the weather, dude. Just
uh-oh. Tell me about it. Tell
just
me
a what. Bad day for me in general. About third cast, got me an 18-inch. Got him on the hog trough. Flopped him off.
Oh, no.
Right in the water. Just got in my head after that. You know, I've never flopped one off the trough.
Oh, you haven't?
No. Yeah. And started throwing my frog, trying to make up, you know, get some big fish, and missed two on the frog. Fought one for a good minute.
Well, we passed you somewhere. Oh, yeah, you were out there.
Yeah, I was on. You passed me on the point. Yeah, and yeah. That's my spot, man.
It didn't pay up.
It didn't
pan
out.
You're in that spot.
And, yeah, man, just got in my head and couldn't get out of the trenches.
You can't break my camera. Don't break the camera.
I won't.
I'm sorry to hear that, but I'm assuming that somebody in the team is going to represent pretty good.
I think so.
Okay.
Hopefully Mr. Eric Porter.
Well, we need to get Mr. Porter in here on the interview.
Yeah.
Well, I'm sorry you didn't have the best day, but I'm glad that you came out. We need your kind of competitive level out here fishing to give it to these guys.
Yeah,
and
man.
Maybe that was your role today, man.
Any day on water is a good day, man.
Exactly. Thanks, Chris. Good to see you, man. Michael James Cates. And I know Michael had something good happen today. What happened, Mike?
I think I caught one on my third cast. Lost one on my third cast. Caught one on my fourth cast. Caught one on my sixth cast. And it was on from then, man.
Wow. It so you're done early?
Pretty much,
you were in your five early.
Yeah, real early.
Wow.
They were eating good, man.
Yeah, the bite was good for you.
But they were little. They weren't big. You know, the reputation of this lake, you got to have 5 20-something inches.
Yeah.
You know, and I didn't do that.
Right. But have you fished this before?
Never. First time.
This was your first moments on the lake?
First time, man.
Really?
I went all the way as far as you could go to the intake arm.
Okay.
Started there and just fished back, man.
Oh, so you put some miles on it.
Yeah, I did.
Okay, good.
I did. Before the wind got up, you know, I knew I could make it back.
Well, what's your impression? Tell me.
Awesome, man.
Isn't it cool lake?
It's real cool lake.
It's interesting.
I tried my best to find some fish deep. And then, you know, after I had my limit, they slowed down.
Right.
You know, I just couldn't do it.
Well, see, when we go to film, we stay off of everybody, so we're deep all the time.
Mm-hmm.
And we'll throw a line.
I tried
one fish deep today.
Yeah, Bo told me don't even
one
worry about
fish
it,
deep.
But
I
didn't, man. I tried at the end, you know, when it was hot, they'd already quit for me where I was.
Nothing, man.
It's weird, man.
That's good. Well, what were you throwing? Tell me what your strategy was today.
I started off with a 316 weight junior and caught a few on it. I caught three on it. No, I caught two and lost one on it, and then the rest was just flipping a big brush hog, man.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah,
I brought a lizard
brush hog.
See, I've had good luck on this lake with lizards, and not frogs, but lizards.
Mm-hmm.
Texas rigged or...
That's what I was doing. Yeah. I had a peg weight, the big 6-inch brush hog, green pumpkin blue.
But they got to be in the depth, and the water temp was up to 87
degrees. Yeah, it was warm, man.
It was really warm.
I haven't seen that warm this year.
Yeah, it got to 87. In fact, in the intake was down only 2 degrees, so that was... It's getting hot here.
Yeah, it's hot, man. The fish were biting. No, it was a fun day. I just couldn't find any big mamas.
It was a good day. Well, let's see how some of the locals do. You know, there's some guys that know the water pretty well. So yeah, we never know where we're going to be. But now, I didn't get you on camera today. Where were you?
Well, maybe that's why I didn't catch a good fish.
Out in the luck, right?
When you came the other day, I called when you pulled up behind me. I needed that today, man.
Good luck for you.
That was 18 and a half or something. That would have got rid of one for me today.
Well,
man.
I work cheap.
I hear you.
Thanks,
Mike. Good luck,
man. Thank you, sir. Here with Elliot Youngstrom. Good to meet you, Elliot. Nice we just met for the first time. It's a pleasure to see you here, man. Thanks for coming out.
Appreciate it.
And you got sunburned along with everybody else real good today.
Just stacking it up, man.
Yeah, well, how was your day?
It could have been better. Yeah. I missed a few and then couldn't put anything on the board. So.
Yeah, it's a tough lake when you're not in the right spot. So
yeah.
And what was your, did you get out and work to scratch all day and follow it, or were you with?
I went all the way to the back of the lake on the far side.
Wow.
Figured we didn't get as much traffic.
All right. Yeah.
But
and there's a lot of people there.
There's a lot of power boats out there today.
Yeah.
So
it was 5-1 spot when we first got out there too.
Pretty busy. It's a nice lake though. It's really pretty.
And have you fished it a lot?
Fished it about 3 or 4 times.
Oh, okay. So not a whole bunch, huh? Where are you from?
I'm from Killeen.
Killeen. Okay, that's good. Well, that's good to see you representing some of the people up there. Are you in the military active duty right now?
I am.
Oh, good. Thanks for coming out. It's really good to see you. Well, I hope you don't give up on us. Please come out and try again.
No, I'll be at the Wild Card.
We'll put our arms around you, man. Well, you have to do well. Good to meet you, man. John Stockman's come in. I'm going to cut him. He's going to bleed. Show me your blood, man.
I did all right. Started the morning. I was paddling. I was going to go all the way up. And I seen all these bubbles blowing up on the surface. And I said, well, it's 5 minutes to first cast. So I sat down there, and within the first 15 minutes, I had my first 3 fish.
Wow.
The smallest was...
The second guy told me that today. You got out there and got it right away.
The smallest was 15 3/4. Out of those first 3. And then kind of struggled for a little while. I was 20. And colon.
Yeah, it was pretty good. Noel, I thought your spot was pretty good. That was a productive area of the lake. And most, when we saw people catching fish, they were down there where you were at, there by the intake. So I think you had it pretty smart. I bet you a lot of people went there early and then just left.
They were under 16.
Actually, I caught my biggest fish on my way back in.
2 minutes!
And I caught 2 more with my third and fourth biggest fish on my way in and the fish.
Yeah, and it got brutal. Did you wear that shirt?
Yes, sir.
Oh, man.
Yeah.
And the hat, that's right. You're wearing the dark hat. Well, more power to you, man.
Yeah.
See, I was using the white bait at 316.
Well, I had the hummingbird hat on today, too, and it's black. And I had to tougher it out, I got off the water at
12:30. He was on by then.
Yeah, it was awesome. Well, good luck to you, man.
Thank you.
It was quite a day, eh, Matt? It was hot, yeah. And I know you could take the sun. You can live out of the sun if it was hot for you.
It was hot.
Well, how'd you do today?
78 and I think 3/4.
How many fish was that?
That was 5 fish.
That was 5 fish. Wow, there was a few big ones back in there, but you didn't end up with a bunch of big ones.
I went to the ground. I only got like an 18 3/4. Everything else was 15 and a half. So.
Well, you were in a good spot back then. Seems like that was a pretty good area.
Yeah, well, I don't fish Decker that much, but not at all. But during practice, I found like a little technique that was working pretty good, and that's what I went with today. And which is pretty much like a sinko with a nail weight in the back, so it kind of goes into the reeds.
Oh, right. Okay. A back-weighted sinko.
Yeah.
Okay.
And, you know, know, just kind of pull it out, let it go back in, pull it out, let it go back in.
Okay.
But, yeah, today, just no big ones, just that one. I was looking for the schooling fish, you know, when I was out here at practice, you know, I was out with a buddy, and he's like, oh, there's the hybrids, and I was like, I wouldn't be so sure about that. And, we threw on large
mouth, right. You know. So. Just some small mouth in here, man. Well, I hope you had a good day. Good day, Steve.
I did. It was hot. It was
thanks for stopping by. Thanks for stopping by. Ocean Kayak guy. Right?
Ocean Kayak.
Go ahead, man. He's half smiling. He's having a pretty good day.
Did all right today. Yeah, not bad.
Tell me about your day.
Oh, man, it was. I wish the bite was a lot heavier, but we at least found a bite, so that was good. Best bite of the day. I flipped a grande bass mega claw right into the reeds. It's barely dangling in the water, and the monster, 17 incher went out of the water, just grabbed.
Oh, really?
And smashed.
Oh, that's cool.
It was so much fun. I was like, oh,
so right off the reeds?
I was all the way up in the reeds.
Oh,
in far up in the good.
Yeah. That's where the action was.
That's where they were. Yeah, the big ones were in there a few weeks ago, but today, not so much. We couldn't find them.
And you came out here with a plan. You've obviously fished this a lot, so you know what you're doing out here.
Yeah.
And it was working. It just seemed to be slowing down to you.
I think we finally got into the summer pattern with the hot temperatures, and the fish are going to start transitioning, pulling offshore a little bit more. Yeah, probably your deep grass line is going to start holding some bigger fish.
What was your method?
Grande bass, flapping crawl was one of them. Another one was a 12-inch wave worm. What's it up? The quick nut selling them. So I bought as many as I could. But I'm sure a power worm would do equivalent. I like those because the plastic's a little tougher. One thing that I did do, Strike King has that structure head now.
Okay.
I was actually pitching that into the reeds.
It's like the jig head?
Yeah, it's like a jig head with a trocar hook on the back.
Oh, okay.
Of it. And with that ribbon tail worm, you pitch it in there, and it just snakes right through, right down the bottom.
And you need that to go straight down.
Yeah, straight down. And it was like, sometimes it was instant, just don't. Wow. And sometimes you just.
And what was your bag today? What'd you pull out today?
I put out 86 and a quarter today.
Oh, okay.
It's not bad. Not bad.
Well, we'll see if anybody gets up there today.
Yeah.
We just might have that.
Yeah.
We might have that stringer.
We might.
Well, thanks for stopping in. Good luck to you, man. Thanks. Good to see you. So here with Joey Montgomery comes in.
You don't need to
talk about it. We talked earlier, so I know you had a pretty fair day.
That's the first day I ever fished this lake. I like it. It actually reminded me a whole lot of a lake I grew up on.
Oh, really?
TPNL down in Hogburg.
I have no idea what TPL down in Hogburg is.
Trading House Creek Reservoir.
Oh, okay, yeah, okay, I have heard of that.
Oh, by Waco.
Yeah, okay.
It set up similar to this, but normally when I fish trading houses back when they used to stock them with red, so I haven't fit a bass fish trading house maybe a handful of
times. They could put reds in here. I bet you that'd be a good lake for it.
I wouldn't.
Yeah, I know. This is too good of a bass fish.
Yeah, I really enjoyed today. Today was my best day of fishing all season.
Yeah, see, this is one of those Austin area lakes that you just go, wow, this is, you can write home about it. In fact, it might show up high on the list this year because Decker's doing so well.
I bet so. I had a game plan this morning. I was going to throw a jerkbait, and the first spot I was at the corner back over here of the dam. And I threw it a couple times, and I got in the grass. I was like, man, I'm going to change this. So I started throwing something else. Then I tied on a little KVD 1.5.
And that was
I went all the way down the bank on the downside up until the reeds are. And I had two of them, two decent. They were like 17 and a 16, something like that. Then I went across the lake, didn't have crap. So I was like, look, I done caught two fish. Let's go back there. Let's just finish it up on the downside. And sure enough, the first pass back, I caught a 23 and a 20.
And people had been all over that all day. People had been back and forth all over it all day.
And I was literally from
shows you.
From here to your sign from the bank. I mean, it maybe a little further off, but not
real
much.
Everything was tied up against it today. There was not much out in the middle. So the lake is changing. We're coming into summertime.
I really enjoyed it. Good day of fishing. The only thing was, is I don't know if I just got too hot too quick or a little tired, waking up at 2:30.
Yeah, there's no wind. But we thought we were going to have a breeze today. People were preparing for wind, and then it's look at this, dead calm still. The
and like you're saying, you know, I came in at 12:30, I think it was, and the last time I was.
What'd you bring in? What was your stringer today?
It was, I think it was 92.
Well, then you're pretty good.
I think so.
You had a pretty good
So, day. I mean, I was happy to have a five fish winner. That's the first time I've had all season long.
We'll see how that holds today. Well, thanks for stopping in, man.
All right, man.
Miss Anglin is here. Angler Pro Jackal, good to see you again. You know why it's good to see you again? This is the first time we've run into each other all year and it didn't rain on us.
Right, this is the best, the best weather. That's right. You're right about that. Good weather down here.
It's a pretty day. Yeah. I didn't see you early this morning, but you got out and stage up early. And how'd you do?
I got five.
You got your five?
I got five. I got a limit. I got a nice, about a 7 pound.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
Okay, what was the length on that?
She was 21 3/4.
Okay.
Yeah, she was really fat, man.
That's a big bass, but that's just about average for a decker. Sometimes.
Really? Yeah.
No, not really, but there's always big fish here. Yeah. It's a sure bet somebody's coming in a big fish.
Yeah, I think was talking to some of the other guys, I think there's somebody out there got a bigger one, but hey, I had a great time. It's nice out here.
Oh, have you fished this much before?
I've never fished this place at
first
all.
First day?
Yeah.
Okay, another guy, first day.
Yeah, this first time out.
Today was your pre-fishing and you.
Yeah.
So, what was the plan?
Well, I got the rumor
that
this place was on fire, frogs. I was crying frogs. I got a couple blow-ups, but I didn't land anything. So I went to what I know is I just pitched up along the weeds.
Okay.
Texas rig, got some there, and Texas rig for me was working. Just
okay, so just to go, you know, and this is a question for me. A guy coming to a lake like this, I know what I do, and I don't know a lake,
right.
And I really don't have a plan, and I've just kind of researched it.
Yeah.
What are you tying on? How many rods you bring? What are you thinking?
I brought five.
So you brought five? You separate them out, or did you split them in half?
I separated them. I had one that was a frog, a big rat I had on there for top water. Then I had a nice little wake bait as well, another type of wake bait style.
Just in case.
Yeah, and then I had a Texas rig, like I said, and then I threw a creature bait for a little bit. And then I kind of got hung up on that, so I just let that go.
You biased it to the rubber side anyway, pretty much.
Okay? Yeah.
That's all right. I would go biased to the crankbait side when I don't know.
And you know what?
And maybe rattle
trap. In my heart, that's what I do.
I go with the trash fish, rattle trap, you know, let's see if they'll chase something.
But this place almost reminds me of Greenville, because Greenville has some grass and a little bit of, like, you know, brush and stuff like this place does. So I just looked at it, I'm like, it's got to be similar. I mean, but it's a lot thicker as far as it comes out more of the water.
There's more grass than you're getting up north.
Yeah.
But again, Athens was an exception to that. But no structure in the middle here, though.
Yeah.
Zero structure. There's not a big, heavy structure there. So that can leave guys that are used to that.
And if you pick up on things, you see how close everybody's fishing, and you kind of know what's going on. So, I kind of picked up on that, but you know. Overall, I had a good time.
Well, I'm going to be curious to see how good you come in there with having the first time.
Hey, yeah, we'll see. I mean, hey, there's a lot of people out here, a lot of competitors and stuff. And I told Bo I was coming down here, and sure enough, hey, I'm here.
Yeah. Okay, well, who do you want to take care of today? Angler's Pro Tackle?
Yeah, Angler's Pro Tackle out of Fort Worth, Rick and Patty up there. Give them a shout out. Anything you need tackle-wise, they have it. Hey, they got Grande Bass. That's one of their top sellers. I get them there, so.
There's your place, guys. All right, Chris, good to see you. Thanks for stopping in.
All right, thank you. Appreciate it, man.
So, Brandon Utley comes in fresh off the Devil's River, man. He's been there 4 days. Look at this tan. Look at this burn, man.
That's right.
You look good, brother. How was your day?
It was awesome. You know, I started out real good. 6:30, first cast. Caught a fish and then kept catching big fish just in the first cove on your right. I mean, I didn't just barely was just like last tournament, right there by the boat ramp.
This guy
killing it, you know. And then the sun came up and everything slowed down.
Yeah.
And I fought to get two more fish and barely got them. So.
But you got your limit today.
Got my limit.
You had a good day.
Good day.
Have you fished this lake ever before?
First time.
Another guy from up north never fished the lake, comes out here and has a good day.
Really enjoyed it.
Well, I see you're wearing your Phoenix shirt. You had a really good day in your last tournament.
Yes, sir.
I think you might be having a good day in this one.
Yeah, there's some pretty good anglers out here. So.
Yeah, there's some really good guys out here.
Sure. Made the drive again.
No doubt. No doubt.
It's good.
It's a good day. Well, anything else? Your highlights and lowlights? What was your biggest fish of the day today?
20 inches.
20 inches? Yeah, okay. That's pretty good.
The first three were on top water and on a spoon. It was a blast because, you know, I just couldn't do any wrong. And then thought it was going to continue like that all day, but it's good.
Excellent. Well, thanks for coming out. Hey, man. Appreciate your time. Good luck to you. Right. Steve Garcia from Wilderness Pro Staff comes in and putting the competition to everybody for sure on your home lake today.
Yeah, I love this place.
Yeah.
I'd fish here every day if I could.
How was it?
It was an awesome morning. You know, it started out big. I mean, just one fish after another. They were, like usual, just crashing shad by the reeds.
Right.
Unfortunately, they were all small, though. That's 16s and 15s and even a 14. That's just bad for Decker.
Right, that's just
great. But, yeah, anyway, it got kind of settled down after a while. That didn't last long and ended up taking off and hitting some bigger fish spots, I guess, places where I don't see as many fish, but they're usually bigger.
So you came off your plan maybe a little bit?
Well, not so much. I mean, it really was. I was planning to hit that one spot first thing this morning for a limit. That worked. Small limit, but it worked, so it kind of took a little bit of pressure off the rest of the day.
Right.
Spent the rest of the day just flipping reeds and fishing some really deep structure that's been holding big fish.
Oh, really? So you knew what you wanted to attack here today?
Yeah, it's one or the other, and it's usually both, so and it's just back and forth kind of thing. So I did. I ended up with one over 20 in the reeds. Actually lost a couple more big ones, but that's the way fishing in the reeds is, so whatever. And I caught a couple of big ones deep, like I was hoping to.
Really?
You guys were over there. You saw me in that little cove, but
right.
It's a big fish cove.
Out in the middle of it.
Out in the middle, you think there's nothing down there, you know, and nobody ever fishes it, but yeah, some brush hogs down there. Picked up two, one was 22 and a half.
And it was pretty warm, so maybe they are moving out just a little bit.
That water's hit 87, 88 degrees.
It was at 87
there.
Plus.
So
I'm seeing the pattern change on Decker a little bit.
It's definitely getting into summer. It's that scummy stuff's hitting the reeds, and so they don't like that so much. You got to try to find some clean spots. Once that grass really starts to get up to the surface, then it's going to be full time.
The sun came out and it went summer pattern. Yeah. It was like a switch turn.
Yeah, it's coming though. But just, you know, the fish are still there. You just got to do it a different way.
Well, Wilderness Pro Staff, he's out here today. Steve, one of the legends in fishing out here. So I really appreciate you coming out and spending a minute with us.
Been a blast. Thanks.
Thanks, Jeremiah Wofford. And you're with the Dallas area or the
Austin?
You're here.
Yeah.
Oh, okay. That's good. But tell me about your day.
I caught a lot of fish, 16 to 17 inch fish. I was flipping reed piles with a grande bass, rattlesnake, and flip reeds all day long, one rod, and caught a good 23 inch fish.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
You brought in a 23 inch fish
today. Where the dam meets the reeds. Caught a good fish right at the end.
One of my fish
where the reeds meet,
ramming it.
And I was stuck in the very back and fishing very far as I could get.
That's going to be one of the bigger ones of the day.
Yeah. Wow. Good. And I lost there a lot of fish around reed piles. Luck. That's what it is.
Any real eventful things happened today?
I measured a 16 and a half inch fish, and I took a nice picture of him, went to go release it, and it went away and turned around and jumped back in the boat.
You're kidding me.
No, and he jumped right back in the boat. I released the head force, and he jumped right back in the boat.
Does he want you to pet him, or what was going on?
I don't know, but I wish it was another big one, and they all wanted to do that.
The fish jumped in the boat at Decker, man. What can you say about that? Jeremiah, good to see you. Thanks
hey,
for your
I
time.
Appreciate it. Good to see
good
you,
Good luck
too.
To you today.
All right, man.
Good friend Bobby the Buff comes in.
Mr. Chico.
We keep meeting this year in these circumstances.
Yes, sir.
We keep winning, man. You having a good day?
I had a really good day.
Well, today I had a record day getting 3 hookups on one fisherman.
Holy cow.
It was you.
Awesome.
Got 3 hookups on film. It was as fun as catching fish.
I'm telling you, I like breaking records.
It's pretty good. Pretty good. Diablo Paddle Sports. Tell me about your day.
Well, I had a really good day. I started out and the bite was on fire. I started with the hollow body frog. I had a limit, probably mid-80s to lower 90s in the first 30 minutes.
Really?
Yes, sir.
Early.
Yep, just throwing that frog, throwing it in the slop, and they were just slamming it.
Well, I can't develop, but you told me early that you got here late.
I did.
You told me you were going to go to that spot, and you were going to go way far away.
Yep.
And we went down to the end, and you were there and had waited out everybody who had finished it, had fished it, then finished it, left. You were there by yourself.
It's turning out to be a pretty good recipe, you know. Get away from the crowd. You know, get your paddle out of the way first thing in the morning.
and then you get to fish all day.
Get there.
You know, you don't have to fight the wind all day. Just go find a spot away from everyone and enjoy the day.
Well, you gambled against the wind, too, because we were supposed to have a heavy south wind. It didn't come. It just died right down. So that's really determined kind of fishing.
Yeah, that worked out.
You were serious about getting over there.
Yes, sir.
You didn't care. You were going to get there, get on the fish, then worry about getting back.
Exactly.
So that's I like that. I like that.
Awesome.
So did you stick exactly to your plan? You know this lake really well, but tell me what deviated.
You know, I pretty much did stick to my game plan. I knew I was going to go for that topwater frog bite first thing in the morning. I knew once that simmered down, I was going to go look for some deeper water, a little bit of structure, and just work swim jigs and crawfish style baits real slow, trying to get that reaction bite. And it ended up working to a T.
Right, yeah. Well, my point there is the determination of going for it. No matter what, that's that attitude.
Yes, sir.
It takes to pull that out. So
in it to win it.
I'm impressed when I see you do that.
Awesome.
And I got to tell you, folks, that I've watched this guy fish, and then I've gone out and tried to do what he's doing. You can't all do that. So trust me on this. I know that.
Most of you can.
Yeah, man. It's work. It's work.
Yeah,
whether
really
you want to deal with that.
Yeah.
And it's a lot of work. But a lot of guys tend to say maybe that's too much. Well, other highlights and lowlights on the day? I mean.
No, you know, my goal was to come in, break 100 inches. I'm pretty sure I did that. Right at the very end, I caught my biggest fish of the day right before I had to paddle in.
What was the biggest fish today?
23 and a half inches.
Okay, that's the biggest I've heard come in today.
Great.
100 inches is the biggest I've heard anybody sit in this chair with.
Well, I like the sounds of that.
So, good luck to you.
Thanks, Chico.
We're rooting for you, and let's see how this goes.
I appreciate you. Thank you, sir.
Here with Robert Supak, also known as Handsome Supak, comes in. How's your day, man?
It's good. Started out slow, went to the dam. Picked up two small keepers and couldn't sit there on it. Had to go to a spot I knew where it was holding fish beginning of the week. So I made the long trek and ended up paying off for me.
We saw you at the opposite end of the dam before 12 noon. So you did make a pretty long trek out there.
Yeah, made a haul.
Yeah,
it paid off. So.
Good. I mean, it seemed like at that end of the lake today, that's where what was really happening.
Yeah, it held up pretty good for me throughout the day. So.
Well, what did you come in with today?
I believe close to 96, 97 inches.
Wow. Okay. So that's going to be in. That's like the second biggest we've heard of today.
That's good news to me.
But I sit in this chair. I don't. I can only hear what you know. Yeah. It's hearsay till the number.
Made me all happy.
You all happy? Well, that's right. You made me happy because you're so handsome and you couldn't sit in here.
Big old boy. You gotta love the chop.
Well, appreciate your time.
No problem.
Thanks for stopping by. Red Whopper comes in. Just saw your brother Jeremiah here a little bit ago and had a pretty eventful day. You guys both had a pretty good day, I think.
Yeah.
How was it?
I got landed two fish. I missed at least 8 or 9 good fish. Lost them in the reeds, got tangled up in the reeds, and couldn't get to them quick enough. And, I don't know if it was just didn't have a heavy enough stick or what I did.
Right. Those reeds are hard to work.
Yeah.
We were just talking about that.
Yeah. I should have had a lot more, but at about 6:15 when I pulled up to the spot I was going to fish, the man, it was crazy, just the fish hitting all in the reeds, and as soon as 6:30 rolled around, I caught one on a frog just like 5 minutes into it, and then I missed a bunch, and caught one more about, I guess, 1 o'clock.
But the afternoon was not a big bite for you.
No.
Slow.
No, yeah. After about 9 o'clock, they laid off. I broke one off on 65-pound braid.
Whoa, really?
And,
busted braid?
Yeah.
We didn't break a rod?
I guess, I think it was more my knot that I tied. I don't know.
Oh, okay.
But it was, it was a good day. It was definitely a good day, man. I enjoyed it, but there was a point there where I was kicking myself for the fish I lost, and I finally hooked into another one and kind of got my confidence back up, and then didn't catch another one after that. So
slowed down, man.
Yeah.
Well, I appreciate you coming in and visiting, and keep your head up, and please come back.
Yeah. Oh, we definitely will, man. Always will. I'm looking forward to next year. I'm looking forward to the schedule next year.
Yeah, did you see it? Looks good. That schedule? Yeah. Yeah, pretty cool. Huh? Yeah. And it's out really early, so everybody can plan. So look at that schedule, Dave.
Yeah.
Thanks a lot.
Thank you.
Here's my good friend Eric Porter. Eric comes in representing Team Croat Jaegers here this afternoon. And
hey, put your name.
How'd you do, man? How did you do?
It was good. At the end, anyways. Lost my first 8 to 10 fish on the frog. Didn't start off good.
Really?
No, not at all.
Well, what brand of frog was that?
That was a bunker.
Okay. I like those with the real legs.
Yeah, I liked it. And then, so I've been throwing it for a little bit. I actually cut a hole in the top of it. I made it real squishy.
Okay.
After that, it was just bam, 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 bam. So it worked out.
On the frog skill?
Yeah.
Okay, good. That's real good.
I picked up a couple more on the run.
Well, I didn't see you out there. Where'd you go?
Off to the right, all the way back. This one, cove first. Was just there with me and Steve Garcia. He was the only other one out there. I was surprised.
No, okay, yeah, I saw him out there.
I mean, he was sitting there pulling me left and right. I was just missing, until about 10 o'clock.
I didn't see your scorecard yet.
But you had a better afternoon than they did morning.
His afternoon's been turning on.
And everybody else had a better morning.
No, I just knew I stuck to those read lines until the afternoon.
I didn't
either. So the pattern was a typical early pattern for you. A lot of these people have already seen the summer pattern pop up. It was slow in the afternoon.
It was. It picked up. I got noon. I think I got 6 fish in the afternoon. So from noon to 1:30, I got 6 fish.
Well, what'd you come in with today? What was your number?
91.25, I believe.
That's pretty good.
We'll see if it stands up. Okay? I don't know about the mouth.
We'll see where it stands. We've got a lot of people here today, so there's a lot of anglers, and we've got some bags yet to come in, so they're still counting.
A lot of them.
Well, good to see you out here. Yes, appreciate you coming in and sitting down and taking a little bit of time.
Yes, sir.
Good to see you, buddy.
Good to see you.
Yeah. Well, we got some video out there of you. I didn't get you on fish today.
Yeah.
Gave you the chance to do that.
I mean, I cut them all in between the 2 times I saw you. Yeah, pretty much. As soon as y'all left, I cut them a bunch of fish, and then you got back and quit catching fish.
So I'm good luck as long as I leave,
right? As long as you're leaving, you're good luck. No, I mean, I had a decent day. I caught a lot of fish. They were just pounding that grinder bass to make the fly today, just killing them.
Yeah, I think third person has given me that one.
Killing them on
that. I love that. That's a great thing.
I just could not find the size station. Yeah, I mean, it's just overall tough day. I mean, I can't really complain. If I was out to have a fun day fishing, it would have been a fun day.
Right, yeah.
So I caught a lot of fish.
Right. Decker's always a good day.
Yeah, Decker's always
fun to come out here because you know you're going to catch something. You're
had a good day. Caught a lot of fish, just weren't the fish I needed. But, I mean, I got a limit and had a good time, so all is well.
Man, I love your attitude.
Yeah, but, I mean, what else can I do, you know?
Well, you're one of our ambassadors. You're one of these guys that are just the sage advice guys of the CCKF tour out here. So we really appreciate you being out here and providing the leadership and repping the friend of bass hook line.
I really enjoy it, man. All the help we get, I mean, Jerry and Grinding Bass is great for us. Me, Dez and Supernova, super guy. I mean, Smith Optics, what can we say? I mean, we're blessed. We're well supported, and we have a great scene going on here. It's only going to get better.
Yeah, life is good over here.
Yeah, it is. It really is.
CCKF, so we're trying to pump it up.
It really
appreciate
is.
Appreciate your time.
Yes, sir. Thank you. Thank you, Bo Reed.
Good luck. Clint Holstein comes in.
Yes, sir.
I keep running into Clint here. Out on the water. I missed you today, though. We got you from a distance.
Yeah.
And didn't get a fish on you.
Yeah, if y'all were out a little earlier, dude, it was hot.
Oh, really?
It was hot, man. I mean, I had a really good day today, but I should have had well over 100 inches. I broke a Phoenix rod right in half.
You're the one I heard about.
Yeah, I mean, okay. I was sitting on the dam. I threw up the dam. I think it was a striper, man. I mean, it had to have been. It was the biggest hit I've ever had in my life.
And, really?
Dude, I mean, my rod, it was a heavy rod, bent all the way over and just completely snapped in half. I went through the line, just thinking the line was still there.
And he broke it. You think he laid into a big hybrid or a strong hybrid?
I don't know, dude. I missed a couple 22s, 23s at the boat. I mean, I ended up 88 in the quarter, I think. But still, I mean, I would have had well over 100 easy. I'm really upset.
Well, yeah. This is a competitive day. We've got a lot of people out in the...
Yeah, but it's just, I'm just here for jackpot fun. It's not yeah, yeah. Series, so, I mean, I'm
you're
here
not here for the points. You're here for the jackpot. Yeah, you're so here to take it.
Free fish. I won the jackpot tournament last Saturday with 96 inches.
So, really?
Yeah, I'd be up there on the fish. You know, it's just... I jinxed myself last night, said I haven't broke off a fish all year.
I don't think so. Oh, you said that
yourself? I said that last night to Derek. You know, I'm like, bro, I haven't broke off a fish all year long.
Okay, sure. Well, I'm not going to say you didn't jinx it, did you?
I think I did, man. But it was still, I had a great day. I mean, that overcast wasn't too bad. It got a little hot, but.
Man, I still, we thought it was going to be a really good, cool day because it started out so beautiful and cool, and then it turned out to be a scorcher.
Oh, yeah. I thought it was really raining and
boiling. Oh, I know, but it didn't.
No, it didn't do anything.
And right now, look at this. We don't have any wind. It's got to be 100 degrees, it feels like.
I'm glad it's over, man.
Yeah. I'm glad you came by and visited and talked. Good to see you. He says, for me, he'll stop and have an interview today because he really didn't want to, and I said, please?
And I'm here.
He's here. You have sunburn, man.
My face has been sunburned for 3 weeks straight.
Oh, you've been out in it.
Well, no, it's just called Texas heat. The summer's here, and I don't know how much of it is just heat and how much of it's actually sun. Because, you know, you put sunscreen on 15 times a day, and it still doesn't work.
It doesn't work. Right. Just forget it.
That's all right.
Well, you know, how'd you do?
I don't know. How do we put this delicately?
That bad.
Not well.
Yeah, okay, really?
Yeah, I was gonna get colorful with that, but you know, children might be watching.
Really, really stinks.
You know,
really
I got to hear some great fishing stories when I got back in. Bo will confirm these fishing stories for us when we get to weigh in, because as of right now, they're just fishing stories. Because I don't believe any
That's
of
right.
I don't believe that anybody could have caught a limit on this lake today. I don't believe that anybody could have caught a big fish. Well, maybe one big fish, but you know, I'm if everything goes according to the way my day went, I'm expecting there to be this tournament to be won with three fish and 10% of the field to have actually caught a fish.
Well, from what I saw, today was like a food truck. Location is everything. Because that's what was happening in those typical spots. They weren't necessarily there, and there wasn't a bunch of schooled up fish like I think some people were looking for.
I'm going to point out the obvious to you. I went and fished where I normally have fish, and my fish weren't there. Now, the obvious thing is, do you know how I could have figured that out? I could have gone pre-fishing.
Oh, you didn't do that.
And when you go pre-fishing, you learn that your normal fish aren't where they normally are, and that's how you win a tournament. When you go in blind and you just show up and say, hey, I've been on this lake before, I'm going to go catch fish.
Here's where they are.
That's when you tuck your tail between your legs and you walk back to weigh in and you have the congratulatory handshake to everybody else.
Yeah.
You know, so you get to go seek out the winners. They don't come seek out you and give you the pat
on
the
back. Well, you've been in the winner's circle this year. You've got your share of...
You know, I've been in the winner's circle and I've been outside of the winner's circle. Let me tell you. I learned a piece of wisdom with this. It's much better in the winner's circle than outside of it. You know.
Well, we've had winners sitting in this chair.
Well, yeah, before I got here. My Smith optics.
There you go.
Were boss today.
They were perfect, right?
I tell you what, everything around me felt like it was melting, and my eyes were the only things that actually felt rested and comfortable, and you know, and I didn't have any eye fatigue. I could see into the water. I could see where I wanted to pitch. I could see that grass that was just underneath the water. There were no fish in that grass, but I could see.
And you could tell there was no fish in the grass because you had Smith.
Exactly.
Well, you know, they should pay you to say that.
You know, the best fish that I caught today came on a Grande Bassinaco.
They should pay you to say that.
They should. Where's the check? But, you know, overall, it's fun, and there's a lot more to these tournaments than whether you catch fish or not. I mean, you come here to you know, for the camaraderie, to see everybody. I mean, this is a great time to come see your friends, you know, people that you can relate to, the people that you can talk to about fishing. And my wife gets mad at me all the time because she, you know, she says I talk fishing nonstop, constantly, all day, every day, and she gets sick of it. So I'm like, okay, well, I'm going to go fishing, and I'm going to go talk to people who want to hear my fishing
stories.
Like
to hear it. Right, exactly. Well, I appreciate you coming out. Appreciate you stopping in. I always like interviewing you whether you win or lose.
I prefer you interviewing me when I win.
Me too. I like when you win too. That's good. Thanks a lot.
All right, Chico, I appreciate it, man.
Good interview.
Some protein shakes. That was my good luck shirt when I was pre-fishing.
Well, did it work?
No, it didn't.
It didn't?
No.
So what kind of day did you have?
I had a bad day. Lost a good fish. It was about 19 inches on the frog when I was taking the hook out at the kayak early in the morning. Missed a couple more fish on the frog, and then it just went dry for a while, and I was like, crap.
Really? Yeah. Now, what brand of frog were you throwing?
I was throwing a Spro.
A Spro frog?
Yeah.
A good hook on a Spro.
Yeah, and... Well, the one that got off, I hooked it so good. Both the top hooks were literally on the top lip coming out of its nostrils. You know, on the hardest part of its head.
Chomped it.
And I literally had to wedge down just to try to get the hooks out.
That was your extra hook set that did that.
Well, yeah, and as I popped the hooks out, I ended up slipping and dropping them.
Here with Mark Nordstrom. Mark comes in representing Papa Chops and... who else, man? You got Phoenix, Hook One, man. You
Supernova and Papa Chops.
How'd your day go?
It went good. I caught a lot of fish. Just not the right length. I think I was doing the right thing. I just wasn't getting the right ones. I started flipping the reeds of the brush hog early. Caught a few on the swim bait. And then as the sun got higher, I switched over and started pitching a D-bomb.
Oh, what is that?
It's like a big creature bait. It's a real fat profile.
What color?
Okeechobee crawl.
Okay. Crawdad, red color.
Pitching it as far back in the reeds, you know, little pockets in the reeds like that. And it'll go down. And
so you are physical in there, getting way back.
Yeah,
I'm going for it today. Shoot for trophies.
Yep. Didn't get a limit until probably noon. So.
And was it better in the afternoon than it was in the morning?
Then it picked up. One afternoon.
The same pattern in the afternoon, boy?
No, when I switched over and started punching, it seems like, I guess as it got hot, they started moving into the reeds.
Yeah, okay.
I mean, there were still some schoolers outside, and I caught some of those schoolers. Some of them sounded nice, but they were 16s, so I left them alone.
Yeah, the small fish. Hey, did you finally come in with today?
84.
84, oh, okay. Good showing. You had a limit. Coming in with a limit is pretty respectful showing for today. Anything else eventful happened? We had a fish jump in the boat today.
Does that count?
No, you had to. I guess you could have waited twice, but you'd have had to hook it. Right?
That happened to somebody, it would too. And nobody knew what to do.
Did he catch it a second time, or did it jump back in the boat and he went, I want to
win? He was paddling and it landed in his boat and he grabbed it.
Well, I guess we'd have to figure that one out. I'd say a no. I put a no on that.
He did not pick it.
Yeah, I'd say you got to have to hook that one with your line and show me you did it. But, you know, I could see a fish picked up once, but it doesn't count. Not video wise. Well, I appreciate you stopping in and visiting.
No problem.
In the same line. Looks good to me. Kevin Werner shows up. Classic white Columbia shirt. I love it. Man after my own heart.
Appreciate it. It's too damn hot to wear anything else.
I know. How was your day today?
Not as good as I wanted to go.
Yeah, but how was it?
Didn't get a limit. Got three keepers. Giant catfish.
Oh, I did hear you yell that out. In fact, it was right before we got there. How big was it?
It was about 29 inches.
Well, that's a pretty big cat for you.
That's a big cat.
Yeah, big enough to...
Would have made a good lunch.
Yeah, bent the rod over, right?
Yeah.
Is it a fight or just did he give
up? Fight. He didn't come up at all, so I figured it wouldn't matter.
Yeah, you knew right away.
Yeah. Caught enough of those, damn.
Well, so did you? You obviously fish Decker a lot, so you had a plan.
I've been fishing, believe it or not, I've been fishing Decker for about a month. Yeah. Fishing for the first time about a month ago. Been doing real well on it, too.
Yeah.
First day I came out here, probably caught about a 97-inch stringer. The next three or four times after that, caught limits. Way over that, actually.
Well,
go figure on tournament day.
Right, yeah, but that happens. In fact, I think I we've had a couple guys that haven't fished it did okay today that have never fished it. So maybe sometimes not knowing anything else. But
I love this lake. I love the setup of the lake, you know, I'm a shallow grass fisherman. It's open for a limit today. Like I said, I figured this would be the lake to do it on. I don't know what lakes we fish this year, but it just didn't happen.
So. Never always works on your plan.
No, the plan did not work.
Well, I appreciate your time.
Thank you.
Thanks for coming out all year. Hope to see you a lot next year.
Appreciate it.
Yeah, thanks, man.
Take care.
Tenth place, 5 fish at 89.25 inches.
Wow, 10 inches.
Christopher Anglin. Come on, clap, man. It's our last event. He came down from Dallas. Chris is taking home a Boca Bearing swag pack with a $40 gift certificate.
Thank you, appreciate it.
Thank you. Good job, Chris. Hey, come on, clap, dude. Ninth place,
yeah, you need to set
5 fish, 90 inches, Brandon Utley. Brandon's taking home a Boca Bearing swag pack with a $40 gift certificate.
Good job, man. Thanks. Come out here and work it.
I think you got to top it up.
All right. Good job, Brandon. 8th place, 5 fish at 90.75 inches, Jeremiah Wofford. Mm-hmm. Jeremiah Wofford's taking home a Grande Bass Pack, 55 bones. Right. Way to stand out.
Yeah.
All right. Good job, Jeremiah. 7th place, 5 fish. Coming down here, putting the whoop on. 91 inches on his first time ever on this lake. Michael James Cates. Michael James Cates is taking home a Grande Bass Max Pack and a Boca Bearing swag pack and a $40 gift certificate.
Thank you, sir.
Brandon Cates. Give it to him, man. That's kayak bass fishing world champ right now. He's taking home more money than any of you. $6,500 he took home in November.
Yeah, that's awesome, man.
From every angler in the country.
Yeah, that's good.
That was good.
Yeah. Right, right.
Sweet, man.
Sixth place. 5 fish. Coming out of circuit, bringing home 91.75 inches, Joey Montgomery.
Okay.
Joey's taking home Grande Bass Max Pack and a Boca Bearing swag pack and $40 gift certificate. Good job, man. Good job, Joey. Way to come down, man. Dude, this is a major feat today. I mean, it's pretty wild. I mean, you had to have 5 fish just to take anything home today. 5th place, coming out of circuit with 92.75 inches, John Stockman! John's taking home a pair of Smith sunglasses and a Grande Bass Max Pack.
Yeah, buddy.
Fourth place, five fish, 95 and a half inches. Derek Taylor! He's taking home $153. A Phoenix rod. And Smith sunglasses. Good job, Derek. Top three. Man, it was so close. Third place with five fish at 97 inches. Robert Supak. Robert's taking home $306. Phoenix rod. Smith Chroma Pops.
Yo, Bobby, how'd you get him?
How'd you get him, dude?
White frog all day. A white frog all day.
It's purple at night.
It's half purple. I can't give a whole sticker away.
All right, he's not giving anything up. Second place. Five fish for 98 inches. Taking home $612 with 34 anglers. Second place, Steve Garcia, $612. How'd you catch a fish, man? Don't bore us with the same old lure.
I got something a little different, so. 420 brush hog. That was really the best thing, fishing it deep. I mean, I did pull some fish out of the reeds. Diesel craw, black and blue, that's the same old thing, right? But anyway, so I branched out a little bit.
More, once again, more money than ever is going out right now to one person. Five fish for 107.25 inches. Everybody here and take the most money I've ever seen in a kayak tournament.
Beat him with the frog.
That's it?
And I caught a few on a swim tank. Mostly on the frog.
I get it.
Everybody gets to eat for feeds back.
Good job, Bob.
Thanks, dude.
Hey, there's your winner! And your ATX circuit leader! $40 on top of everything else that's been paid out. Combined, or I'm sorry, 21 fish for 23.50 inches, adding $340 to his current take, bringing it to a grand total of $2,329. Bobby the Boof, your ATX circuit leader. How'd you catch your big fish?
I caught that big fish on accident. I had about 10 minutes left to fish, and I sling this frog in the reeds, and I get it hung up, of course, reel my slack, and I'm yanking on it. Then I yank it through the reeds, and it
7 pounder just engulfed it, and that's it.
Yeah,
$2,329.
Awesome.